It's really hard to see anything. I'm back out doing some more landscape photography and I'm heading up towards Pike O Blisco. And I've done it again where I started walking and then I zoned out and now I'm like halfway up. But I've just noticed over there, there's a couple of herdwitch sheep on that horizon. Then you get in Crinkle Crags with all the light breaking down. And this is pretty similar to a photo that I've got before. I'll put it onto the screen. But the only difference is, with that first photo, I think I was up on that bank in there, but we could possibly get two sheep in a similar composition, which could be good, because that's like one of my favorite photos. So I'm gonna stick on the GoPro and we'll try and sneak up on them. They'll probably run away now I just started this. Hopefully that sun goes behind that that first mound. That'll make life a bit easier for me. I think that one might be quite nice actually. There's quite a lot of empty space there though. We'll try and get all three of them together and then head off. I'm struggling a bit here. Whenever they like line up with a nice composition, it's when that sun is like sticking out behind that, what's it called? It's the one before you get to Crinkle Crags, and it's like really harsh and it's causing a lot of sun glare. So I think I might call it quits there. I might have one or two that are okay. I'm not fully convinced, but I want to watch the sunset from the top of here. Still got plenty of time, but we'll go and find a composition that'll work and then we're not rushing. Not a bad view, is it? I've made it up to the top now, and it wasn't as bad a climb as I expected. It's been really hot today, and I thought it was going to be like just like a really hot and sweaty one, but it was about the right temperature, so it was a really nice walk up. But I'm going to quickly show you the views, because the sun is about there, and I want to get the sunset behind Crinkle Crags, which is the hills that were behind that them herdwitch sheep back there. We have done that walk before. I'll link that down below. But from here, so you got the cairn at the top. You got the, it's like a half dome shaped shelter. We might use that in the sunset photo. It might look quite nice with that gray area. Then it'd be like a silhouetted area. Then maybe an orange area. That's my theory anyway. Then you got the path that leads up to Crinkle Crags. Crinkle Crags is there. This is Bowfell here, and this is the band. And then you got Great Langdale over on that side, and you can look down into the Langdale Valley. And you got Side Pike there, which means Bleatarn is probably about here. Then over in that direction, you got Windermere, and I can't think of what these ones are, but they look quite nice. I'm not sure how long you've been watching this channel for, but I came up here at the start of winter, and it was a different story then. I got to the top, and it wasn't too bad when I got here, but then when you looked over at the band, you could see the snow coming in, so when I first got here, it was green like that. And then the snow, it was mainly hail actually, and it mostly went in my eyes. And then that came over here and I had to hide behind this shelter for probably 30 minutes.
Turns out it was that's a hailstorm. It's gone grey. Look at that view.
And then when I came back out, that side was all covered in snow, and the valley was covered in snow as well. And then we managed to get a little bit of nice light for about 5 minutes, then it clouded back in, then I had to go down. But it was a fun adventure. I do like that kind of thing. But I think what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get Great Langdale while that light is quite low, because you're getting some light at the top there and shadows down in the bottom. That's pretty much the only composition I can see right now. The one I want is that way. So I'm probably just going to take in the views for a little bit, have a bit of a play with the camera, try some compositions without thinking about it too much, and then see what we can come up with. Can you hear like a whirring sound? It's coming from near you. Sounds like a really high-pitched drone. I hate them things. Yeah, this is working quite nicely. There's some light spots at the front here. Then it's sort of in the shadow down there. Then Great Langdale. I can't remember the name of the one on the left. Pavey Arc on that side, that's in shadow. Harrison Stickle. Maybe it's Harrison Stickle. I'll have to double check. But there's some light on the tops, and there's some light in a diagonal line going across halfway. I think both fell might actually look quite nice. But I really don't like it when you get sun flares from the sun. So I'm going to wait until it drops down a little bit further, because I just know that's going to annoy me. Most things annoy me. So I'm just going to take in this nice view over here, and that should be good. Where's that noise coming from? I'll quickly run through this shot while we're waiting. So I've got just a two-stop hard on, two-stop hard grad on, and it's just cutting off a tiny bit at the top, because you can get all of this area properly exposed in one frame, but this area here is a little too bright. So if we stick that across the top, you can see it just balances it out better. You can fine tune it when you use this holder. I think in about 10 or 15 minutes, that'll be low enough to get photos in that direction. It's really hard to see anything. Are you getting blinded by it too? Yeah, you see that glow? That glow just goes like right into your eyes and blinds you. I'm gonna stay on this side for a bit longer. The sun's started to drop down now, and I think we should get away with shooting into the sun now. So I've got a frame set up. Do I want that in? We'll catch up in a sec. I'm not sure if I want the stone thing in or not. I might have to bracket on this one, because the sun is breaking out, and it's sort of cutting through the light really nicely. You can see it here. I don't know whether I want it like just the hills or with this as well. I'm gonna have to move fairly quickly though and make a decision. I think it is better with the shelter in, because on its own there's not a lot down there. There's not a lot interesting going on the foreground. Maybe if we got really low down. But then it starts cutting into the sky a bit. No, this is about right, I think. Maybe as that sun drops down, it'll get a lot softer and it'll balance out a bit nicer. Because this is still like really bright on here compared to that on there. And I'm not sure how well it blends together. But it does look nicer on the back of the camera. Often looks nicer on the camera than in real life. I'm going to have a little play and not think about it too much. I often overthink things when I do the vlogs. So I'm just gonna, just take pictures. I'll try and show you what I'm looking at through the camera. So we're getting the shelter here. So it's sort of coming right up to the edge. Then you get this really dark bit, then the orange bit. We're not getting that glow like we were getting before here. It's just sort of a solid color now. But I'm hoping that it gets like a really nice soft light around here now. And then we can get a panorama maybe, because that orange glow is spreading behind Great Langdale now. We didn't have that before. I don't know what to do actually. This isn't the sunset that I was expecting. I was expecting more clouds. There's no compositions that are like really jumping out at me. Maybe we'll get the band. There's a little bit of water glistening on it here. Maybe we could get a composition like this. You're getting all the silhouettes off in the distance now as well. I'm not going to bother with that way though. It's kind of flat over there. I think this is where the better light is. I've got a feeling that I've seen the best of the light now. I've got the photo that I came for, looking down onto that shelter with Crinkle Crags behind it. The sun's dropping and the light's just like really flat, and it's really pretty actually, but it's not like that dramatic. Pretty's nice though. I'm gonna get some more pictures. I'll do a blog post as well if I get any more, and I'll put that over on adamkappa.co.uk. But my options are, I could try and get a few of just Crinkle Crags, maybe one of Great Langdale. Now there's more of a glow in the sky. We can avoid that farm down in the valley this time as well and just get Great Langdale, them hills off in the distance. Can maybe walk over that way and get them back hills more prominent. But I've got a feeling all of this side is gonna be in shadow in about 10 minutes. So I may as well walk down, because it's quite a long way to the car. You didn't see it. I'm like a rocky scramble down here and probably 40 minute walk that way, which isn't the best thing to do in the dark. I've done it 3 times now. But I hope you like the video anyway. Some of you have been asking for sunsets for a while, and I don't often go out for them. It's not really my scene a lot of the time, but it's good to mix it up every now and again. Fingers crossed some of these will be available as prints over on adamkappa.co.uk. And I'll link all the walks from the hills that we've seen. So we've got Great Langdale, done that one. Got Bofell and the band. Got Crinkle Crags. So I'll link them 3. And I'll see you next time.